Hey everyone, this is Benjamin here from the African Geek and you are welcome to this fantastic tutorial inside of Canva. Today we are going to be looking at gradients and we'll dive deeper to understanding what gradients are and how to use gradients inside of Canva. So if this is something you want to know how to do, stay tuned and I will be right back after the intro. So you'd realize that these days with my thumbnails, for example, I usually go with gradients, and if you also follow me on Instagram, you realize that most of my carousels, you know, get to have gradients in them. And one of the questions I get to have the most is, how do I get to, you know, use gradients and all of that? People usually love to understand, and I wish I could just pull up the comment, but it's just so much work. But the thing is, using gradients is very easy, okay? And the only thing is, you have to understand what gradients are. So first of all, what is a gradient? And a simple definition is, a gradient is a color transition from one color to the other, and it's also a gradual blending, you know, from one color to the other. So that's usually what gradients are. And another thing you should also know is, with gradients there are several types. We have the two color gradient, which is just one color to another, and we also have the three color gradient, which is one color to another color. You get it? So it's just a three color gradient. And we also have four color gradient, but usually in Canva I haven't seen four color gradients yet. Some elements are three color gradient and some, or most of them, are two color gradients. So now, how do we work with gradients inside of Canva? Here I am in Canva, and I have a blank canvas at the moment. To use gradient, the first thing you have to do is to come into element, and in element you have to search for gradient, okay? So once you search for gradient, you will see so many gradient elements here, and depending on what you want to use, I'm not going to be so specific on which one you have to use, but one thing I would also want you to have in mind is, some of these gradients do not give you the option to change colors, okay? So you have to make sure that you are choosing any gradient element over here that allows you to be able to change colors. So to get some of them, you can come into graphics, okay? And in graphics, we have this one, for example. It still doesn't give us the option, and usually, okay, this should be able to. It looks like even with this, we do not have the option to change colors, okay? But let's check with this one. Yeah, so this one gives us the option to change colors, and you can see with two color gradients, it moves from one color to another, and this is a perfect example of a two color gradient, okay? So I'll just make this big so that it's easier for you to see it on your screen. All right. So one thing about gradient is, if you are choosing a two color gradient, the first thing you need to know before you can use the gradient is the colors you want to use. So if, for example, you have this two color gradient, then ask yourself, which colors do you want to be using for this gradient? Because some colors would work well in a gradient and others will not, okay? So you should first of all know the colors you want to use, and the second thing is knowing which color you want to be starting with. So you can see in this case the blue starts first before the purple, okay? So that's another thing you need to keep in mind, okay? So now let's see how we can tweak this. And what I usually love to do is, when I'm choosing my colors, okay, or when I want to work with a gradient, I usually use colors that are next to each other, okay? So for example, we have this red over here, okay? And a perfect one can be you know, this is good, but it's too sharp, you know, it's just too much. It's way easier using colors that are next to each other so that the blending becomes, you know, we usually have a smooth blending. So if I come to the next color, a color I can use can be yellow, okay? It can be yellow, so you can see, because the red now moves into the yellow, you get it? So with this, it makes it very interesting to the eyes, you understand? And another example can be, let me just reduce this and over here, now duplicate and also bring it here. And another example can be, let's say I can pick this green over here. No, for the first one, you can see this doesn't look good because first of all, they are not next to each other, you understand? And the combination is just too bad. So let me use the lighter green for the first color, and the second color we can consider a blue. So you can see how this gradient also looks like, because the colors are really next to each other, they are very close to each other. So now let's check for a third example, and with this one we can come with maybe a blue And you can see, since these ones are even next to each other, the gradient is beautiful. Okay, but with this, I will just choose, let's say, a purple here. Okay, and you can see how this gradient looks like. So this is what I do, and I can't, and for now I cannot attest to other techniques other people may have in terms of using gradient, but I'm just sharing with you what I do and how I work with gradient, and this is how I usually use my gradient. Okay, so for example, what you see in my thumbnails, the gradient I usually use is I start with my brown color, which is a yellow, and with the next color, okay, the second color usually is an orange. Okay, so usually it's an orange or so, you understand, and I can make it lighter. Okay, so this is usually what I do for my gradients, and these are very interesting ways to work with gradients. Okay, so let's say we have a design, okay, and I want to use a gradient as a background. I can just make this bigger, you understand, I can just make this bigger and just apply anything I want to use on my gradient. So you can see it's looking very clean and very beautiful right now. And if we are to use the other colors we made mention of initially, you can just see how it looks. Okay, so we just see blue, and with the next color, instead of the orange, I would use a blue or even a purple. This is beautiful, this is so beautiful. So this is a very simple way to work with gradient for your backgrounds, and I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and I hope you also now be able to use a lot of gradient in your designs. Now your name is Benjamin, and always remember, there is no limit to creativity. And before I go, one thing I also want you to know is there's a Telegram group I created, and I want you to be a part of it. So there's a link in the description box below, and find it and join it, and I will be looking forward to meet and greet and create with you. I will see you in my next video. Bye for now.